What makes all the difference in a business? Like maybe a business not doing so well, or even in life you have a certain problem. What makes the difference? Actually, something called ideas, or an idea. A single idea can change everything in a flash. Okay? So whatever problem you're facing, whatever problem you have maybe in a business, a single idea can change everything. Indeed, I can even add very confidently, ideas, one idea has made somebody billions, billions of dollars. Just one idea. Yeah? And of course, that would translate to trillions of Kenya shillings. Okay? Now, what am I talking about? I'm talking about ideas that you come up with, that you sit down and come up with, that change everything. They change the ground rules. They change some of these ideas, even create completely new industries. Now, let me just give a few examples, and let me give you examples from our local Kenyan marketplace, right here in Kenya. Okay? A few years ago, there was this unknown, small, upcoming comedian. Yeah, comedian, somebody who makes people laugh, cracks jokes, you know, good for relaxing. Because as stress increases, there's a very high demand for relaxation. And making people laugh is a very popular form of relaxation for most of us. Even I love comedians a lot. So this guy came up with this idea and thought, why don't I take this to another level? Yeah, I'm a small comedian here. Why don't I take this to another level and actually provide something unique for people? Now, the idea they had was to have a competition for stand-up comics. It has never been done before in Kenya. Yeah. So this small comedian did it. And one thing led to another, and to another, and finally they had the grand big idea of having a show unto themselves, where they would invite these other comedians, and they, of course you know who I'm talking about already, yeah? Churchill, everybody knows him. Now as I speak today, Churchill is not a poor person, yeah? Daniel in the book is his real name, he's not a poor person, okay? And it all started from a single idea. There was another even more dramatic idea on the Kenyan marketplace, that produces a product which you use every day. Yeah? Michael Joseph thought of the idea of, that used to be the CEO of Safaricom, he thought of the idea of transporting money, or rather, having a money transfer service using mobile phones. Yeah? Now, I need to give you information here that you may not be aware of. New ideas are not well received. Yeah, let's get that. Especially some of the most sensational new ideas we have had in history were never well received. Sometimes people laugh at them. Mostly people say they'll never work. Most of the times people receive them with a lot of boredom, a lot of, shooting them down. The M-Pesa idea was no exception. And to make it worse, the M-Pesa idea came at a time when Safaricom had just come from another idea which didn't work too well. You'll remember the Simu ya Jamii. That was a total failure. It was an idea. Sometimes ideas don't work, sometimes they work. But the important thing is to keep on going. If you try an idea, it doesn't work, try the next one. Now, the M-Pesa idea came at a time immediately after the Simu ya Jamii had failed, and it had cost Safaricom a lot of money. Some people say millions in losses. Okay? So, of course, when he brought this other idea, people are not buying it. And of course, there are skeptics. Kenyans will steal you blind. Or con men are going to have a field day with this, you know, and so on and so forth. But today, the M-Pesa idea has spread beyond the borders of Kenya. In fact, has made Kenya famous. Just a single idea. Now, let us be honest. The single largest idea most businesses have, whether it's a new business, whether it's an ongoing business, whether it has been around for ages, is that problem of getting customers, getting more customers. Yeah, because more customers is more money, more profits. Okay? And in this age of fierce competition, changing technology, etc., etc., getting customers has become a huge problem. And this is the perfect place to introduce ideas that completely change the scenery. And this has already happened quite a lot of times in all kinds of places. Yeah. And that's why I'd like to introduce a book to you called How to Get Plenty of Customers. Yeah, How to Get Plenty of Customers Right Away. This is an amazing book. Yeah, maybe let me just talk about one idea that I actually read in this book that is amazing and that will just blow you over. There was this girl selling a consultancy service. You know, I think that's one of the hardest things to sell. You know, you're a consultant, you're trying to sell your services to improve maybe a business. Mostly it's to improve a business. And this guy couldn't get customers. So the idea that was introduced by a consultant to them was the idea called service, you know. So what happens, instead of waiting for the customers to call you or advertising and you don't get them, they created a very nice list of prospective customers. Then they went out to these customers, not to get business, but to do a survey. You know, you ask questions, you know, what do you prefer? What service do you use currently? What problems are you facing? And so on and so forth. Now, of course, this is usually in the form of a questionnaire. So they went out and asked these people questions. And guess what? From that small idea, they gained a lot of business. I think some of you understand the consultancy business can get what I'm driving at. Because when you go and you ask a customer what is your problem, people open up. They say it's this and that and that. And therefore, it's very easy for you to position your consultancy business to address those problems exactly. So when you come and you tell a client, instead of coming to a client and tell them, please buy from me, I'm the best consultant, I've done this and that, that's boring. You'll never sell. But if you come to a client and tell them, this issue you have with valves in your factory, which has cost you 10 million over the last 2 years, is a very serious problem, and I have a solution for you. You'll get their attention, and I'm sure you'll get their business. And that's just one idea I read out of that book. The idea I've given is rather complex, but there are other very simple ideas, like for boutiques, salons, barbers, you know, any kind of business you can think of. Like if you have a small store in town, you're trying to sell something, don't have customers, you have a movie shop, whatever it is. That book is amazing because it covers all those businesses, whether it's a complex business like the one I've just explained or a very simple business that just needs simple ideas to carry on. It's amazing, and I recommend it for you. Now, there's a very interesting offer that actually I can give you in Kumekucha, whereby I will be able to give you that book plus another book, 101 Brilliant Business Ideas That Will Work in Kenya. Now, these books currently are selling on OLX, and their combined value is over 2,000 shillings. They are selling elsewhere. The combined value is 3,000 shillings or more, yeah, in bookshops and funny places. Sorry, not in bookshops. They're not being sold in bookshops anymore. The stock ran out, imagine. But now they're available only digitally, which means you can get them instantly. That's the advantage of technology. So anyway, these books are selling for a lot of money outside. But you can be able to get both books right now, in the next few minutes, for only 999 shillings. Wow, that's quite an offer. I suggest you go for it. Yeah, all the details are on your screen right now. They're also in the comments area below this YouTube video. Go for them, get some ideas into your life, and bring that change into your life. This is Chris Kumekucha commenting on business. Thank you. Bye.